put money down on a brand new tomb because the one he gave Jesus, Jesus only needed it for the weekend. If he had not been so fast, and those women with Mary and all of them would not have brought spices to anoint a dead body, but they would have brought Jesus' travel bag and a fresh pair of gaiters, amen, and a brand new suit so he could freshen up, because it had been a hard weekend. If they had just slowed down and not been so fast, they would have been at the tomb ready to celebrate. Got the tambourine and the praise dancers ready. They got the choir, amen, ready. They got the organist ready to key it up. Somebody play my shout music, because I'm coming out. I'm coming out. I'm coming out. They should have been waiting for Jesus to get up on their getting up morning, because they expected it. They should have expected it because Jesus said it. They should have expected it because he said it. And then suddenly, come on, somebody. See, when you get the revelation of Jesus getting up and what it means, you can shout, because that means if he got up, I can get up too. And you can tell Satan, not so fast, because my Savior hung, bled, and died, and he's risen, so I can have life more abundantly in Jesus' name. When the enemy rises against you like a flood, you can tell the enemy, not so fast, because the Lord will rise up a standard against you. You can tell the enemy when he attacks you, not so fast, because you're covered by the blood of Jesus. When the enemy attacks you and attacks your health, you can say to the devil, not so fast, for by his stripes I am healed. When the enemy attacks your power, you can say, not so fast, because the joy of the Lord is my strength. When the enemy tries to attack your fans, you can say, not so fast, because the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. When the enemy tries to attack your peace, you can say, not so fast, because through Jesus, I get a peace that passes all understanding. When the enemy tried to attack your mission in the kingdom, you can say, not so fast, for the Lord knows the plans he has for me, for my good and not my evil, to bring me to an expected end. When there's trouble on every leading side, and you need help to make it through, you can tell the devil, not so fast, because I will look to the hill from whence cometh my help, and I know my help coming from the Lord. Can I tell you, when you get the revelation, the right revelation, you can tell the devil, hold on, wait a minute, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke you, and not so fast, not so fast, not so fast, in Jesus' name, not so fast. Oh God, we thank you today, amen, for the power of the word and the foolishness of preaching. I want you to know today, I want you to hear this, that on this resurrection Sunday, God wants to resurrect you. Amen. Oh, it might be some things in your life that look dead and dormant. Amen. But I know and I believe that my God can do anything, that he is a raiser of things that are dead. What was dead now shall live. I'm here to tell you, if you look dormant even to yourself, if it looks like you ain't got nothing going on that's right, you can't seem to get it together, everything is against you, can I ask you this? Please consider your ways. The book of Haggai said, consider your ways. See, it's a reason, amen, why you're restless. It's a reason why you can't sleep at night. It's a reason why you got extra anxiety. It's a reason why you're feeling all out of sorts. Can I tell you, you just need a little more Jesus, amen? I thank God that we got wisdom and we follow the steps and the protocols of what's out here for us to do and live. But the Bible gives me another recipe to live. He said, the Bible said, look up and live. Look up and live. Look up and live. I want somebody to get this today, that you need to look up, because your help ain't coming. Your help ain't just coming from that stimulus check. Your help ain't just coming from FEMA. Your help ain't just coming from the vitamins you've taken, amen, and the foods you eat. But your help comes cometh from the Lord. And I want somebody to know he is the mover of heaven and earth. He is the lover of your soul. Can I tell you this? If you already a believer, amen, you need to put it all in God's hand. Not all, not just some of it, but all of it, amen. And if you don't know the Lord and the pardon of your sin, here, I got a word for you today. And that word is look up and live and come unto Jesus, amen. Come unto Jesus just as you are. You don't have to make excuses for what you've done and how you lived. You don't even have to make an excuse, Lord. I know it's trouble out here. And folk don't think I'm just coming to Jesus because it's trouble. Well, I'm here to tell you, trouble or no trouble, amen. It's a smart decision. And if it takes trouble to bring you to Jesus, that's all right too. Because at the end of the day, if you come to Jesus and ask him to forgive you for your sins, believe that he is the Son of God, believe that he hung, bled, and died on the cross and rose on the third day, you will be saved. And I'm here to tell you, in the Bible, it said there are some that come through trouble. There were some that would come through tribulation and trial. But as long as you come, so this is my prayer for you today, that you hear the words coming from my mouth and you understand my heart. If you don't know Jesus, you are going to hell. Amen. I say that with all the love I can muster. If you have never asked Jesus to come into your heart, if you're not living for him, amen, you are not going to reign with him. You're not even going to see heavenly places. Amen. You're going to lift your eyes up in hell. I ain't trying to scare nobody. I just got to tell you the truth. You might not never hear the truth ever again in your life. Let me tell you, we were all born in sin and shaped in iniquity. But this is another truth, that while we were yet sinners, God commended his love for us, that he sent his son to be the Redeemer, the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. And you are part of that. You are part of that. You qualify. You qualify for God's love. You qualify for God's salvation. And you qualify to sit in heavenly places. Pray with me. Dear Heavenly Father, I am a sinner. Dear Heavenly Father, I ask you to forgive me for my sins and forgive me of all my sins. I believe in your Son. I know he loves me. I believe he died for me. I believe he got up on the third day, and he is welcoming me right now. He came for me. He came to save me. He came to love me. If you have accepted Jesus, if you have prayed that prayer, if you are praying that prayer, you have now just accepted Jesus in your heart. I don't care if there ain't nobody around. Testify to the air and tell them I'm saved. Turn around and tell somebody that I'm saved. Turn around and tell somebody that, yes, Jesus loved me, but this I know because maybe I ain't read it in the Bible, but this crazy preacher told me so. Now I'm going to go read it for myself. In John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Enjoy your everlasting life. Be well. Be blessed. Amen.